Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you, sir.
People that have gone before us, and we give thanks for what they have done to preserve our liberty and our freedom. Thank you. Dear Father, now please be with this elected body. Help them to make decisions tonight, tough decisions, but help them to make the best decisions after thorough consideration. Again, Heavenly Father, thank you for your many blessings to us. We pray and ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge
allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Yes. Item 3, adoption of tonight's agenda. Ladies and gentlemen, are there any changes to our agenda tonight?
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to see if we could ask if the board will agree to it and that discussion about what things we need to do about the roads that the city is supposed to be building that they're Mr. Denver deadline for.
Can you do that now in the work session? Now, do you have any information?
I'd rather see the work session.
I'd like to do it now. Once again, we're waiting. And we were told, I think, by their lawyer that there was absolutely no way they were going to be late. And they're late.
Are you making a motion?
Not quite yet. You know, we've been working with GDOT. We've raised $200 million, and we got the money for those roads, but we're waiting for them. Why?
Well, but I believe, we can't discuss it. Make a motion
for that. I make a motion that we add to the agenda a discussion about any action that the board might take to find out why or what we're going to do to see to it that the road gets built from Pilgrim Mill to whatever road that goes by Costco, I think is the one I'm talking about.
You talked about the one for the city.
From the goes actually from the Boys Lodge down to
Portless Foster Green.
Pilgrim Road.
Yeah.
I'll second the motion.
Well, second this item, you get passed at item 6. New business, Commissioner Bob?
Yes, sir. That would be one.
Have a motion and a second to have discussion on completion of road. Any discussion? Please vote. Fails 3-2.
I'm going to see it added to.
I make a motion on that. We add it to the next June, first work session in June to be more prepared.
Second.
Is that all right, Council? Go ahead and make a motion after a work session.
It's fine.
Thank you. Motion second to add to work session, please vote. Motion carries five zero. Any other changes? Counsel, or Doug, first?
I have no.
Counsel?
Mr. Chairman, I have two. Both of these are time sensitive, but will require a court visit. The first one would go on new business. This would be new business number six. It is a proposed intergovernmental agreement between Forsyth County and the Forsyth County Board of Education with respect to an intersection upgrade at North Forsyth High School. I will explain the details if it is added, Mr. Chairman.
So moved.
Second. Motion second to add an IGA with the Board of Education. Vote approved. Please vote. Six, five, zero. Got your four fields.
Mr. Chairman, the next, thank you for that. The next item is a proposed general lease and settlement of claims between various homeowners, Forsyth County and the Timberline at Lake Lanier Homeowners Association. Again, I will discuss the particulars if it is added that will require forfeits.
So moved, Counsel. Motion second to add Timberline and Forsyth County. Please vote. Motion carries five, zero. Counsel?
Mr. Chairman, thank you. That's all I have.
Do I hear a motion to adopt the agenda as amended?
So moved.
Second. Motion second to adopt. Please vote. Carries five, zero. Item four, announcement for us tonight. We are honored to have the DECA from South Forsyth, correct? Commissioner?
That's correct.
She and I attended the presentation of eight teams. It was thoroughly enjoyable. I know more about picking up litter than I ever did before. I was actually just picked it up and threw it in the trash can somewhere. Ms. Mills, would you like to introduce them and tell them something about?
I would. If their teacher would come up, Deborah Moore. I have been, the landfill is in District 4, so I would say that I've probably gotten more complaints than probably the other commissioners in dealing with our ongoing litter problem in Forsyth County. And I tried to look and think of all different ways that we could combat this problem. And years ago, I sat on Teacher of the Year, one of the hardest committees I've ever been on. And had it not been that I had gallbladder surgery, Ms. Moore would have been the Teacher of the Year, I am certain, because she so deserved it. And I was so impressed with what she does with the DECA program at South Forsyth High School. And if you will, I can tell, but I would like for you to share just a little bit about, she has the largest DECA program in the nation. And if you will, share just a little bit about that DECA program. And that's why we went to them. I thought, what better way to go to kids to ask for help with a litter campaign and with to try to educate our young people about the problems we're having with litter in our county, to talk to them. I went in and spent an hour talking to them about the trash and the trash on our roads and at our parks and at the lake and different places and the different kinds of trash. And Tammy Wright went in and talked to them and engaged with them. And then they went out and did extensive research. And then we went down and they did a little competition like what's the show?
Shark Tank.
And we had Sheriff Piper, myself, Chairman Amos, Jeff Bearden, the superintendent, Darla Lye, James McCoy, Valerie. We all went down, did I forget anybody? And we judged the competition and we picked the top three. And that they're going to present, the top three is going to present to the board now their findings. So, Ms. Morphy, we'll go ahead and tell us a little bit about.
I am a marketing instructor at South Forsyth High School and also the DECA sponsor. And DECA is a professional organization of marketing students. There's more than 240,000 DECA members around the world. And South Forsyth is home of the world's largest DECA chapter with 1,313 members. We have completed various real-world business projects, marketing campaigns, marketing research projects, advertising campaigns for various businesses throughout the state, including the Avenue Forsyth, which is now the Collection, Finish Line, corporate headquarters, had our students to create a marketing strategy for their stores nationally. We also actually did a statewide campaign for the Georgia Department of Education that included commercial spots and print advertisements. And the advanced marketing classes were challenged to come up with an advertising campaign to promote anti-littering in Forsyth County. So this has been a great project for us. We do have three teams that will be presenting tonight. And without further ado, I would like to introduce group number one. This group is Daniel Briggs, Sydney James, and Lindsay Nance. So, as you guys know, the universal sign for stop is the stop sign. And so we created a plan surrounding the stop sign because all we want to do is stop littering. And we chose this sign because it reaches out to every single generation. It doesn't matter who you are, you're going to recognize the stop sign. So without further ado, we want to introduce you to our plan, Literally Stop, putting an end to Forsyth County's worst habit.
First, we created two billboard designs. Our first billboard reads, it is illegal to run the stop sign, and it's also illegal to litter. Do you follow both laws? And our second billboard reads, you spent over 50 hours a year sitting at this light, but it only takes a second to pick up a piece of trash. Why is littering a bigger problem? And the goal for our billboards is to make people feel accountable for what they're doing and also to provide them with facts.
As you all know, social media is very impactful in today's society, so we chose to use Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook to reach the most people that we can. And with that, we're going to choose to take pictures of certain areas of Forsyth County that have litter, and then after a little pickup, we're going to take another picture and then post them in almost like a side-by-side collage and saying, which would you rather see? For example, you can go on Sawney Mountain and look at a hiking trail and then pick up the litter afterwards and then take a picture and say, which would you rather see on this hiking trail? For the radio ads, we did two of them, as you see in your marketing plan report. First of which will appeal to more of the listener's emotions, since it involves dialogue between a mother and her daughter. And the second of which appeals to the curiosity of the listener, because it's mostly sound effects.
We then created a promotional video. In the video, we're going to have a blackboard, and at the top of the blackboard, it's going to say what you know about Forsyth County. And then people of all different ages, ethnicities, will have a post-it note saying what their favorite thing about Forsyth County is. Then each person will go individually, place what they love about Forsyth County on this board, and then the camera will pan over the board, seeing all the things people love. And then the screen will come up with the question, if you love this county so much, why ruin its beauty by littering? And then the next slide will come up, and it will have our logo on it with our website, so people can go to this video.
So we also created a basic flyer, and that flyer states, would you want trash in your yard? Of course not. Forsyth County doesn't want it on their yard either. And the whole purpose of this is just keep people accountable and hold down that moral of treat others the way you want to be treated, treat your area like you want to be treated, because you're living.
We'd like to thank you guys so much for allowing us to come out. And right before we go, we're going to talk a little bit about the website that we designed.
We then created this website basically to be the hub for the campaign. People, after seeing the advertisements or seeing our billboards or the video, will be able to come to the website and find ways they can get involved. And they can also post what they look up for Forsyth County on the website as well.
So our final component of our projects are sort of two in one. So we're going to create two promotional items, first being a car magnet, which will be a stop sign. A stop sign is something you see on the road. So hopefully when people see that on a car, they're going to realize, hey, that's a stop sign. Let people see what it's all about. And then our second is a temporary tattoo. And that will be involved into our school involvement, which is, I feel like, the key of our campaign, because the key is to keep people educated. So what we are going to do is in every Forsyth County school, elementary, middle, and high, we're going to institute what we call Literally Stop Squads. And their mission is going to be to keep their school grounds clean. And our main goal of this is to hopefully, if they keep their school grounds clean, they'll keep their homes clean, which will take it home to their parents. Because we want them all to learn together, and hopefully the parent sees their child doing it, they'll do it as well. And then we're also going to institute trade characters into the elementary school portion, and it's going to be a police officer who will come and educate, and then a real life-size stop sign with arms and eyes to have something goofy for the kids, and who will put the temporary tattoos on them, So hopefully they'll go home and their parents will be like, hey, why do you have a tattoo on you? And hopefully they'll describe the message behind it. So that is all we have for you today, and we're so honored to the opportunity because we all love this county, we all live in it, and hopefully this can help in problem littering. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you all.
Campaign idea, the Keeping It Clean campaign. When I was in sixth grade, I participated in Piney Grove Middle School's G3, where I helped clean up trash alongside the road. It was then that I realized that Forsyth County did have a litter problem. That's why today we are so excited to present to you our ideas to keep Forsyth County litter free for generations to come.
First, we want to show you our postcard. The postcard will be sent out to every resident from Forsyth County. On the front, it has littering law in Georgia that prohibits the littering on the highways. Underneath has maximum, minimum, and average fine for littering on our highways. And the last part is how the community can help to prevent the littering. Inside, you open it and it says congratulations. And inside is a fake $500 bill that says don't waste it all on a litter fine. And on the back, it has the sponsors, and this is also where the addressing stamp will go. The great thing about not having an envelope is that it doesn't only save money, but it also, not only does it save money, but it also saves paper. And research has shown the more you can make a postcard to surprise and stop them from recycling, the higher response rate you'll have for it.
One of our social media ideas is to utilize an app, the Keeping It Clean app. This will involve three different games to help target kids. The first game is Whack-A-Bug, similar to Whack-A-Mole, where you would try to kill the litter bugs. The second is Chase the Truck, which is similar to Subway Surfers, where you chase behind a trash truck, cleaning up trash alongside, or when you're chasing it, you try to clean up trash, which will give you power-ups. And the third is Chunk the Junk, where users will flip the screen and they'll try to get the trash into the trash can. If they miss the trash can, a litter fax pops up on the screen.
Okay, next we have a radio run. This is what you hear when you throw the old fast food bag out the window. This is what you hear when a cop sees you throw the fast food bag out the window. And this is what you hear when you get fined for throwing that old fast food bag out the window. Littering on Georgia highways can cost up to a fine of $1,000. Don't trash if you can't pay the cash. Brought to you by the Keep Forsyth County Beautiful Program. Our plan for the radio advertisement is to advertise it on Forsyth County's only local radio station, 91.5, and also 99.7, which is an Atlanta-based radio station because most people in Forsyth do commute. Also, in addition, we kind of talked about Pandora the last time, and we got the prices back for that. And we found that for audio ads on Pandora, it'll cost $8 to $12 for local airing, which is the great thing about Pandora, because you can customize it to geographic regions, age, and listening habits.
We have five different promotional items. The first will be, the first is Spirit Towel, and they'll be customizable for each Forsyth County High School. These will be handed out at athletic events for fans to wave during the events. The second is a Frisbee, featuring our character, which is the litter pug. These will be handed out 10 per elementary school for kids to use during recess, PE, etc. The third is a card magnet, which says honk if you love the environment. The fourth is a pin, which has our slogan and website on it. And these are great to be handed out at dentist offices, doctor's offices, or anywhere else you might need a pin to fill out different forms. And our last is a reusable water bottle, which features the slogan, the logo, and the website. Our video commercial features a man driving down the road. He then throws out his cup onto the street littering, and the deer cup pops out of nowhere and throws the cup right back at him to add a humorous effect. Then the man and the deer stare at each other for a few seconds until the man speedily drives away. The deer then looks back at the camera and smiles, and the slogan, "Consider Before You Litter," pops up on the screen. The narrator will then say, "Brought to you by Keep Forsyth County Beautiful Program."
Rise up, Falcons fans. Our slogan endorsement is none other than the Atlanta Falcons. Currently in Forsyth County, there are 20 elementary schools, and our plan is to have 5 different Falcons players go to 4 different schools each. The plan here is they can read books about littering or even play fun anti-littering games. These kids see these players as their heroes and will sure be influenced to not want to litter and hopefully pass the message on to their parents. And we contacted Chris Millman, the Director of Community Relations for the Falcons, to ask for an accurate price, but he said we must fill out a form due to the fact that the players' prices are decided by their agents individually. However, most of the player appearances are defined as community service, so what the civic organizations will do, we'll give them honorariums or donate to a charity of their choice. And then next, we have our slogan, Consider Before You Litter. Our logo, which is Keep Forsyth County Beautiful, and the background is actually like linear, which gives just a very like a at home feel. And then lastly is our trait character, which is the litter bug, and he says, don't be a litter bug, listen to the bug, and he says, don't litter. And for any other information we didn't have the time to talk to you about today, please refer it to it in the marketing plan report. We'd like to thank you so much for giving us the opportunity today to talk to you about our ideas. We hope to assist you in keeping Forsyth County clean and make people consider before they litter.
Hi, I'm Blake Brooks.
I'm Lee Caleb.
Hi, I'm Katie Powers. In 2014, Forsyth County Schools had the highest SAT scores of Georgia's 28 largest school districts and also had the highest graduation rate in the state. We are in the top 20 richest counties of all the United States and are known for our amazing school systems, kind-hearted people, and amazing land. We want to continue this legacy for many years to come, and that starts with us. We are taking a stand and helping to keep our county clean.
So as you can see, we designed a new logo for this affiliate, and it's just a simple blue circle with the shape of the state of Georgia that's very recognizable to everyone who lives here, and in it is an actual picture of a beautiful nature that's found here in Georgia, and it's just very simple, easy to put on different promotional items. For our slogan, we have, if you wouldn't brag about littering, why do it? And this sort of calls out to us and shows how littering reflects on everybody as a person, and that's not really how you want the world to see. We've also designed a few flyers that can pass out of different establishments, such as fast food establishments, where a lot of litter does come from, with cups and bags. And this is the first one that says our slogan at the top, and it will feature a website and logo on it as well. And it's just a teenage girl taking these stuffy pieces of trash, and this is kind of ironic because no one really posts that on social media, and nobody does want anything like that on social media because that reflects on them, and again, that's not how we want people.
Here is our newspaper ad. What we did is we took the outline of the state of Georgia again, and we have a picture of the recycling plant, and it shows all the garbage, and this is perfect for the newspaper because we can use it in black and white or in color. And what we're going to do is we're going to post it in the Forsyth Herald, Johns Creek Herald, and all the other different newspapers around the area in the county, and this is basically just to kind of promote the keeping the county thing. I'm going to put it in the people's hands.
These are some of the billboards promotions that we designed, and the first one is just a simple hello, I am Sitter, and this basically just says hello, I am a litterer. And this is kind of ironic also because, you know, this is not how you want to have yourself be perceived to others. It's kind of, you know, just you would not want people to know you as a litterer. It says our slogan at the bottom, if you wouldn't brag about littering, why do it? And then this is also, we have two options for this one. This kind of shows which would you brag about, and this kind of shows half of one area that has litter and trash and that's in black and white, and the other part that is clean is in color. That same billboard is just with the other side that has trash and in color, so you have different options to choose from. This is also one of our promotion ideas. It is called the Litter Letter Project, and other affiliates have done this as well, like Keep Louisiana Beautiful, and basically you take about 6 to 8 foot letters that are made out of chicken wire, and you fill them with actual trash and litter from your county to spell out words like care, pride, and clean. And here they showed, you know, like 78 gallons of litter from the streets going to that K that's right there on the board. So it kind of just shows, you know, people that this is how much trash is in there, and it kind of, you know, makes a positive message.
We designed several promotional items that you can use to pass out to people in the county. First one is a bumper sticker, which can be used in cars because that's where most litter happens. People throw it out their car window, and so just getting them right at the source will help preserve them to do that. And it just says, you know, keep the pledge, don't litter. Again, to just remind people when they're in their cars. We also have a driving mail idea, which is just a simple postcard. And on one side, it's very informational. It reminds people of the consequences of littering and has a QR code that will lead to our website and just encourages them not to litter. The other side featured two detachable stickers that are just the Hello, I Am stickers, and one of them says, Hello, I'm a litter. The other one says, Hello, I'm keeping my county beautiful. And hopefully they'll use the Keeping My County Beautiful one to help promote, and they will realize that they don't want to wear the Hi, I'm a litter one because nobody wants to introduce themselves and make a first impression.
A trade character, we have the litter lizard and the cleanup kangaroo, and these two characters will be full-size people costumes, and they will go to the different schools, and they will go to entertain the children while also educating them on the importance of keeping your county beautiful and not beautiful. Our celebrity endorsement, and I hope you all watched the Hawks game last night, even though they're terrible loss. But they've been doing very, very well this season, and statistics are going all around about how much money they've made just off of advertising slots and such. So we would love to use them as our trade characters. And like the previous group said with the Atlanta Falcons, we would have the starting lineup. We would have all of them go around to different schools just to help educate the children and kind of make it cool to not live.
And we also have already contacted the Hawks, but unfortunately we've not heard back yet, but hopefully we'll hear back soon. For our radio PSA, basically this is going to be going on the station. It'll be a 30-second advertisement, and it's going to be a kind of skit that is a Litterers Anonymous group, and so it's going to be, you know, kind of a more comical and humorous ad, but also get the really attention across. And also we are going to be advertising on Pandora and Spotify to have that same promotion, but have it to be for the younger audience, for people that, you know, are listening on their phones.
We've signed a TV PSA as well, and it's just the you know, archetype of a classy, like, Southern lady, and they're just gossiping on their porch, bragging about their children, and the two of the ladies have very, like, you know, accomplished children, and then unfortunately one of them just has a child who's a litterer. And when she tells the other ladies that, she's kind of ostracized for that, and again, just kind of shows how, you know, you want to make your parents proud, and you want to have something to bring your mom to and brag about to her friends, and just kind of get them to message across.
All right, we have a social media page. We want to start off with Instagram, and what we want to do is to go around and take pictures of the county. I want to take pictures of the ones that are trashed with litter and show them how beautiful it could be and the potential that these areas have without the litter. And then we also want to have a... the plan. This basically just kind of describes everything. We created a Gmail account for all of the Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook accounts that we've created already. So they're all linked together on this one Gmail account. The YouTube we will use for the cleanups and stuff because they make cleanup videos to kind of recap the entire cleanup. So we'll have those posted on there also with other with our PSAs. Twitter will post information such as times for cleanups, things that they can do to help, and Instagram, like I already said, with Twitter. Thank you very much for listening to our campaign.
So in 2015, Forsyth County Schools ranked above the national average in college readiness, and our county ranked below the national average in employment rates. In 2016, we want to add a new statistic to this list. We want to make Forsyth County the cleanest county in America, and we truly believe that our ideas will help the colleges. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And what we are hoping to do is take all of your ideas, and Ms. Wright is going to meet with her staff and with the Gilstrap Beautiful group, and then we're going to all come together and come up with future ideas to create a great campaign.
Yes, Jody's right there.
And Jody, look at her right here. She'll tell us how to get more. Can you get us? You get perfect.
Commissioner Malcolm, step one side or the other. Okay. I'm missing.
No, but you can hate this more than anything in the world. That matches your suit.
Got us, Jody?
Yes. Perfect. Thank you.
Your parents can come down.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay. You guys can come on down if you want.
Margaret,
If you have documents for the commissioners, please provide a minimum of 7 copies and submit those to the clerk when approaching the podium to speak. 1 copy will be retained by the clerk as part of the permanent record. Those who wish to speak must sign up by completing a public comment form available just outside this room. Information regarding specific requirements to address the board is listed at the podium. Please state that information prior to speaking. Per the county's broadcast policy, the county is not responsible for statements made during public meetings and does not warrant the accuracy of such statements. The public comments portion of the meeting is intended to allow speakers to make a verbal presentation to the board. The number of speakers is limited to 10. Speakers are selected on a first-come basis and will be heard in the order in which they signed up, with the exception that Forsyth County residents will be heard first, with non-county residents to follow until the allotted time has expired. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. The public comments portion is limited to 30 minutes. Mr. Chairman, there are no public comment speakers signed up this evening.
Thank you, Jim. Item 6, I hear a motion to adopt the minutes of the regular meeting public hearings of May 7, 2015.
Second.
Motion is second. Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Item 2. Is there a motion to adopt the minutes of the work session and the executive session of May 12, 2015?
Second.
Motion is second. Please vote. It carries 5-0. Is there a motion to adopt the consent agenda?
Second.
Motion is second. Please vote. It carries 5-0. Item 8, old business. Mr. Brown, number 1.
So this is one AZ150001. This is a commission district number 2. This is a decision for H. Gilstrap Development regarding the amendment of zoning conditions 5, 11, and 14, and the deletion of conditions 4, 7, 9, and 12. Based on zoning application 3636, public hearing was held May 7, 2015.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. I believe you said this is decision only. Commissioner Towns, district.
Could you go back to the first condition, please? I believe this is a first for this type of condition. Counselor, yes?
Yeah, I think it is. I mean, this is a condition that has been negotiated with the developer, and it's one that's actually not governed by the CUP process. It's one that they have independently agreed to be subject to. It fairly closely emulates what we might come out of a CUP, but it's not subject to the CUP. So I'm very comfortable with it. It's what you might have seen in a general senior housing product. But they have not only agreed to that, but they have also provided some draft deed restriction language, which I have signed up on.
Thank you. It is a, at least one person 55 years or older, age restricted, but also you'll read about halfway down these covenants and restrictions. Shall provide that no persons under 18 or under will permanently reside in this development without some proof of significant hardship. I'd just like to point out a few of the things about the conditions that we've added. The up to 132 units, so that's an additional 18 units than they were allowed to build before, but the building with the 175 beds goes away. There are, we've enhanced the exteriors of the building, stone and brick. We have increased the size of both the attached and detached units. The development is now gated. And the last thing, I'm missing something here in the... The organization established no more than 10% of these may be rented. So I feel it's pretty locked down. Therefore, I would make a motion with respect to old business number one, the zoning conditions placed on ZA3636, MAZ150001 to be approved as displayed, please.
Second. A motion and a second for approval with the conditions as shown. Any other discussion? Please vote. Motion carries 4-1. Item 2, Mr. Brown. Old business 2.
SP150001 H. Gilstrap Development LP. This is also the Commission District Number 2. The applicant is requesting sketch plat approval to develop 74 attached residential units and 58 residential lots on 67.161 acres, the property that is currently zoned Res 4. The property is located at 5801 Old Atlanta Road. The public hearing was held on May 7, 2015.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. This is also decision only.
And these are the exact same conditions.
It goes to Commissioner Tanner. Yeah, the word for word is exact same number.
Okay. So, with that in mind, I want to make a motion to approve the sketch plat on behalf of H. Gilstrap Development LP to develop 74 attached residential and 58, that's up to 74 attached and up to 58 residential lots on property currently zoned Res 4. Sketch plat SP150001 with the conditions that are displayed.
Second. We have a motion and a second for approval with conditions as shown. Any questions, comments? Please vote. Motion carries 4-1. Number 3, Mr. Brown.
Old business item number 3, AZ150006. This is a Commission District Number 2. This is a decision for the Davis Real Estate Group LLC regarding the amendment of zoning conditions number 3 and number 4 and the deletion of condition number 2, which was placed on zoning application 1831. The public hearing was held on May 7th, 2015.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. This is another decision only by Commissioner Tam. Let me get your district in. Commissioner, I've seen that. Looks like it's going to be a great development down there, Brian.
Yes, and it is being developed by, it was owned by the same people that own the adjacent daycare. Back up just a little bit. Please, this one. Right there. That's good. With that in mind, I would move to grant a request on behalf of the Davis Real Estate Group LLC to amend zoning conditions placed on ZA1831 Meadows Partners LLC on AZ150006. Those that are displayed.
Second. Motion second for approval. Item 3. The conditions are shown. Any other discussion? Please vote. carries 5-0. Item 9, new business. Mr. Brown?
Business 1A.
1A.
Zoning application 3715, 3D project management, David Gay. This is Commission District Number 3. The request is to rezone 9 acres from A1 and CBD to A1 with a conditional use permit for a proposed church totaling 31,609 square feet. The property is located at 5455 Campground Road and on the west side of Campground Road, approximately 600 feet north of the intersection of the Atlanta Highway. The Planning Commission recommends approval of this rezone from A1 to CBD with conditions. The public hearing was held on April 28, 2015.
Thank you, Mr. Brown. Commissioner Levin, I believe this is your district.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Make a motion for approval of the ZA 3715 from A1 and CBD to A1 with a conditional use permit for the proposed church with 181 parking spaces as presented.
Our schools. Exactly.
With the conditions.
Have a motion and second for approval. Number 1A under new business, the conditions are shown. Stated by Commissioner Levin. Any other discussion? Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Before we do number 2, I believe Commissioner Levin has a statement.
I do, thank you, Mr. Chairman. On item number 2, 3, 4, and 5, I will be recusing on these items as I did in the order session.
No, I do 5. You do 2.
Three. I'm so sorry. 2, 3, and 4, I've been refusing as I did in work session. On abundance of caution, because this is having to do with pay raises for our employees, and my wife is an employee.
Thank you. Thank you, Commissioner Lynn. Thank you. Okay, so the vote shall be maximum 4. Item 2, director personnel.
Yes, Commissioners. In March of, 24th of March, Evergreen Solutions presented to the Board of Commissioners here findings from conducting a comprehensive competition study. At that time, they presented the application of a 2.2% COLA and two market adjustment options, one being bringing salaries to the minimum, which was option one, and then the other, the second being bringing salaries to current range penetration with a cap of 2.2%. At that time, the board asked that this be presented to the Finance Committee, which was done on April 14th. The Finance Committee did take into consideration that $1.33 million was budgeted in the general fund to address study findings. Before you, in your books, is a spreadsheet listing various options that were brought to the Finance Committee with the cost broken out by various funds. The Finance Committee does recommend option 2, which was the current range penetration capped at 2.2%. And under that, they also did recommend that a 2.2% COLA be applied retro to January 1st, 2015, and that the market adjustment of option 2 be applied on pay period beginning June 29th, 2015. And you'll note on the spreadsheet that would cost the total general fund approximately $1.36 million. The Finance Committee also recommended, as presented, as to specific supplements that are non-mandated supplements regarding whether the 2.2 COLA should be applied to the supplements. The Finance Committee did recommend that those also be applied to the supplements, as listed in the spreadsheet. You should have a copy of for approximately an additional cost of around $7,500.
Is that it?
That's it.
Now, if it gets approved tonight, how quick would it get out to the directors and elected officials? Our new patient.
Well, that information will, if approved tonight, the detail. details of that will be issued tomorrow to all employees and to department heads. The COLA would be approved tonight, would be in the paycheck of June 5th, and that retro amount will be in that paycheck. And as mentioned in the market adjustment, though, would be applied on the June 29th period.
Thank you. Any other questions from the board? I know we haven't talked about this much. Do we hear a motion for item two? I make a motion to approve the compensation study as presented by Pat. Approval of item two, option two, Pat. Are we going to do it?
Yes.
Complete option two. Second. Okay. Motion second. Any other discussion? That gets Pat.
And the 2.2% COLA.
And 2.2% COLA. That's presented by you.
Yes.
Motion second to approve. Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Levin has accused yourself. Item three.
Yes, Commissioners. Also, as part of the study, Evergreen Solutions presented on March 24th. The study recommending that a new salary schedule be adopted, and based on their findings, at that work session, they asked the board had asked it to go before the finance committee, and that was done so on April 14th. And the finance committee did recommend that the new salary schedule be presented. Before you, you should have a copy of the proposed salary schedule and the current salary schedule. In the presentation by Evergreen, they did come to that conclusion because they found that the midpoint, as noted in the proposed schedule, is what the current market is, and that is bringing that schedule to that. In addition, they found that really the minimum, midpoint, and maximum for the current salary schedule was very below the market. The new proposed schedule brings all of those levels within less than 1% of the market, and also that the current salary schedule was 10% below what the spread should be from minimum to maximum. And that new proposed schedule does bring that up to approximately 57%.
So one question, Pat. We've gone down from 45 grade assignments to 28 now.
I'm sorry?
We've gone from 45 grades down to 28
yes.
grades.
Yes, many of those were not being used. There were no classifications assigned to them. In addition, there was a very small dollar difference between many of the grades, and that does result in a lot of compression. So they did recommend that that dollar difference between the grades be expanded, and you'll see in that proposed that there is a wider range there.
Now, if there's some disagreement between directors or elected officials about the grade level, who decides? Will you decide that, or will you get with the directors or officials?
As with in all of our processes, they could submit a job reclassification request to have that analyzed and looked at. But as it stands, this is we hired Evergreen to do a salary survey. They are the experts, and I wouldn't want to sit there and try to second guess and pick and choose based upon that. I would want that to then go through the same process and be looked at in detail as if the process that we currently use, if they feel that something is not correctly graded.
These will go out tomorrow, but at
this information would be released tomorrow if approved by the Board of Commissioners.
Any other questions for item three? Do we hear a motion for item three? I make a motion that we approve the proposed salary range schedule as presented by Pat Carson. Motion is second. Any other discussion? Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Bent being accused. Item 4, Pat.
Yes, this is a resolution for the board's consideration and approval to adopt policy adjustments which address the salaries that are at or above the maximum salary grade. This is a recommendation as a result of the study that Evergreen made. It is important to note that 8 of 12 local government surveys apply a cap, and that's what these policies are addressing, is to modify some type of cap. That for utilizing lump sum payments, or if there is an increase such as a merit or COLA, that individuals that are at or above the maximum would still receive this, but as a lump sum, it would not increase your salary further to go above the maximum. That amount would be considered part of compensation for retirement plan purposes. And those policies also reflect then that a merit, if it is a merit amount that the board has approved as an increase, since merit reflects previous performance, that the lump sum would be issued to those individuals at the same time when others receive it, which is typically the first pay period of the year. Whereas a cost of living reflects a regional cost of living index and is prospective. And the policies show that that would be issued as a lump sum at the end of the year. If separation of employment should occur during the year, that person would still receive a prorated amount. The Finance Committee did recommend the adoption of those policies as presented, and also recommended that any 2015 lump COLA that is applied also be followed, this policy be applied at the end of the year.
Thank you, Pat. Any questions at this time?
I just have one question, Pat. I've never been a part of government before and working in government. Is it typically the way we've done this, being pretty quiet about it all or not disclosing the particulars about individuals or about the medians or about the what the chart says in particular about the ranges and how it falls with particular employees and whatnot, and not giving that information out to employees to look at till after the vote instead of before? Is that typically the way it's done in government?
Well, if you look at, this is a pay plan for the, and a pay schedule for the county to start looking at how individuals may benefit or not benefit. Does compromise the integrity of that plan, which we did pay money for an expert to develop and prepare. And if you are then looking at that, it does give an appearance that there could be biases presented and that there could be favoritism. So for that reason, even the agencies that you go in contract for do not recommend that individuals sit there and start picking through and that politically gets involved in that.
But just for the record, we've seen nothing.
And yes, you have not. For that, specifically for that reason, so that it is, there's could be no perception of any favoritisms, whether it be towards an individual, towards a department, or towards a group.
Okay, thank you.
Any other questions? I'll make a motion that we approve the resolution of Forsyth County Board of Commissioners amending the Forsyth County Employee Handbook. Council, I don't have to mention all the change, all the regulations.
Do not.
The resolution does it. It's in our book.
Second.
Motion is second. For approval of the resolution, any other discussion? Please vote. Motion carries 4-0. Commissioner Bent being recused. Item 5. I'd like to recuse accuse myself of talking about the trail, redirection of the trail, because it may or may not involve the property I do own. So I'm going to accuse myself of any discussion of vote. Turn it over to Vice Chair Commissioner Wills.
Okay. Mr. Mayor, are you handling that?
Yes, thank you.
Okay.
Commissioners, this is a topic that we have discussed in work session. This topic is a redesign of a section of the Phase 5 Greenway Trail, a section that begins at Kelly Mill Road and generally goes north, crossing Shamba Gap Road and ultimately ending just south of Valley Lane. We have made an effort to redesign this route to try to make it with gentler slopes. The original design had several switchbacks, some fairly steep slopes in it, so we've tried to reroute it to make it a more gentle slope, and also to try to move it a little further back from the main roads. I think this will result in a very nice, beautiful trail. So I have brought this to you with a recommendation that we go ahead and execute a contract agreement with the Ponding Company to redesign this trail. This would be in the amount of $149,075. It would also allow us to move forward with the procurement of the right-of-way that we need for the trail. So it would do those two things, redesign and allow us to move forward once we get the final plan with the right-of-way acquisition. Now, we have spoken, I've worked with Commissioner Levin, we have spoken with several of the property owners, and we do believe most of the property will be donated, so we're very appreciative of the owner's cooperation. I'll be happy to answer any questions.
Is this the one that we were talking about, that it ends, and we were worried about the next phase?
Yes, Commissioner Mills, it is. And we were looking to stop before it goes to this neighbor to see if there's a different route. After further driving around, taking a better look, we're hoping to approach the city to see if we run along their sewer lines and not run through people's yards and through their front yards. It's going to be much better route. But this will stop just prior to that, because that discussion is going to have some taking place.
So voting on this will not impede upon, we won't put ourselves in a bind of the option for the next part of it?
No, ma'am, I don't think so. I think we can go ahead and design this section, but and then if we decide to relocate this, the next section that you've referenced, a section just north, then we will have a proposed new route, and we'll work with Ponding Company to then redesign that section. But we're not there yet. This is only for the section between Kelly Mill, generally northward, up to just south of Valley Lane.
Okay, I just want to make sure we're safe on this section. Looking forward to the next section, we're not putting ourselves in any type of a box.
Yes, ma'am, I believe we'll be fine.
All right, do we have a motion?
We have a motion to approve the Ponding Company to do the design and to start acquiring right of way of the Phase 5 Greenway up to the point which the mayor has described.
Not to exceed.
Not to exceed whatever metric. We're not to exceed $149,075. Second.
We have a motion and a second. Please vote. That passes 4-0. How many? 4? Yeah, 4-0 with the chairman name is refusing.
Thank you. Commissioner Mills. Item 6, Councilor. IGA, Board of Education.
Board members of the commissioners, thank you very much. This was an item that you added by way of vote at the adoption of the agenda on a time-sensitive basis. I appreciate that. You have in front of you, and I want the record to reflect, Mr. Chairman, that I have handed out, because this was an added item, I have handed out an intergovernment agreement at each of your stations, also to the clerk. A and that is what you are reviewing this evening. This is an intergovernmental agreement proposed between the Forsyth County Board of Commissioners and the Forsyth County Board of Education. It pertains to a upgrade at North Forsyth High School for an intersection upgrade that, interestingly, both the Board of Education and the Board of Commissioners have planned to build. So you basically have two governmental entities that both have the same plan to do the same improvement. So trying to seek a win-win out of this, the thought was that perhaps an intergovernmental agreement might be of assistance here. So let me tell you what this intergovernmental agreement does. First of all, it anticipates that the county will undertake the improvement at North Forsyth High School, this intersection improvement that we are already legally on the hook to do. And so therefore, as you might suspect, then the Board of Education doesn't have to do it, but there will be a pool of money they otherwise would have to spend that they no longer have to spend on that. Well, this is where the intergovernmental agreement comes in, because what this will commit them to is to use the amount that would otherwise have been used for that improvement at that school for beautification efforts. Now that's a very broad overview. Let me tell you about the meat and potatoes of this. The meat and potatoes of it is that Exhibit A, that is should be loosely in the IGA, that is actually the improvement. I will tell you, this is not finalized yet. And so that's important, because as soon as this design is finalized, I'm going to be bringing this design back to you and have you ratify. You may ask then, why did you put this on a time-sensitive basis this evening on the agenda? Because I would like to get the IGA ratified, the verbiage, the terms of the IGA ratified, and get it to the Board of Education so they can consider it as well and hopefully approve it. And then to the extent that this design changes, I'll bring this back to you at a subsequent meeting for ratification. With respect to what it provides, first of all, we anticipate the cost to do this upgrade to be around $200,000. Now, as you know, it's a roadway improvement project. We don't know the exact amount until we competitively bid it, so that's anticipated. So we're going to do the upgrade. Now, what is the Board of Education going to do in return? Number one, first of all, they're going to set up basically a beautification committee, of which the principal will be the head of that committee, and they are going to agree that whatever the cost is of this ultimate design improvement that we're going to do, they will agree to spend that on beautification projects that are recommended by this committee up to a maximum cap of $250,000. Now, when do they have to have these projects done? That's really not the point of the IGA is not to give them a specific timetable. The point of the IGA is to keep the money for this intersection at that school, and that's what the IGA does. We have to have our improvement done, top of page two, no later than the start of the 2016-2017 school year, which we don't think will be a problem. That's pretty much it. It's pretty simple, but it's pretty clever at the same time.
Thank you, Councilor. Any comments from the board? It's a good shared project with Board of Education.
That's correct.
Thank you for working on it. May I have a motion?
Yes, sir. I'd like to make a motion that we approve the intergovernment agreement between Forsyth County and the Forsyth County Board of Education as presented by our county attorney.
Second. A motion second for approval item six, IGA between the Board of Commission and the Board of Education. Please vote. Motion carries 5-0. Council, general lease of settlement.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you very much. This too was added by way of motion and vote on a time-sensitive basis. I have placed on the screen, I hope you can see it, it's a general overview of the county. I'm just trying, I know the first question the board always asks me whenever we're talking about resolving issues is, where is it? So I'm trying to show you, do you see the red dot and the arrow pointed at the red dot? That may not be very clear, but that red dot is some parcels of land in Timberline and Lake Lanier subdivision. So I hope that perhaps you all can see generally where that is in the county. All right, and then if you will switch those pages now, I'm going to focus a little bit further. This is within the subdivision. You see there's a parcel in red and then a parcel sort of outlined in blue, 7695 and 7685. There are some stormwater issues on those parcels. And of course, this Board of Commissioners doesn't need to talk about stormwater issues too much to know that those sort of claims can be very expensive to litigate. And typically, the county is whether or not we actually incur liability. We typically are on the other bottom side of the V when there's litigation. Somehow or other, we always end up being part of that case. And even though we've got a pretty good success record, they are expensive to litigate. So some of the commissioners have been working with members of the Timberline and Lake Lanier Homeowners Association to come up with a settlement agreement that would sort of acknowledge that we may be involved in litigation if it is brought, but otherwise get a complete release, not only from the HOA, but from the two property owners. Our contribution would be a maximum cap of $30,000 for any repair, and by the way, we think the repair is going to be around $60,000. Our maximum exposure would be a cap of $30,000 or some amount that is less than that, that is 50% of the total repair. So if it's a $50,000 repair, our maximum contribution would be $25,000. We anticipate it'll be around $60,000. Our exposure will be no more than $30,000. This would get us, if it in fact is accepted by the parties, it'll get us a full and complete release with respect to any of the stormwater issues on those two parcels. I would also ask, however, that if the Board of Commissioners is willing to offer up this release and this financial contribution to it, to sort of buy the peace, buy our way out of any litigation, that you put a time clock on it. I think that that will incentivize everybody to get real reasonable. So I would request the Board of Commissioners is interested in approving this release that you put a trigger that there is 45 days from the date of any approval for this agreement to be accepted by all the parties on the agreement. And if it's not accepted by everybody and approved by everybody, it is deemed withdrawn. That's my request to you, Mr. Chairman.
So I move council with a 45-day cap for approval added to the rest of the settlement. All right?
Yes, sir.
Second. Second.
Motion second. Any questions? Any votes? Motion carries 5-0. Council, send me for executive session.
Mr. Chairman, there is none.
Thank you, sir. Now I hear a motion to adjourn.
Move.
Second.
Motion second to adjourn. Please vote.
Vote LCO.
Carries 5-0. And adjourned at 6:06.
How can you never get ahead of it?
We just want
to keep trying.
My pleasure. I think that got us done, didn't it?
I thought I was ahead of it.
We're working on it. Probably a whiff.
They came out and picked that up. But we've got a van, and the sheriff says once he gets the jail open, he's going to start having prisoners pick it up. We've gotten a van and with equipment, and GDOT's provided that.